My name is Kelly Sanderbeck and I work with PCC Farmland Trust. To our knowledge, we're the only organic farmland trust in the country. And we are different from a lot of land trusts, from most land trusts, in the sense that we work to get farmers on the property so they're actually working farms, not just rural landscape. When the trust was started, we would purchase the entire property and lease it to a farmer. But then as time went on, we started to realize that we could do more faster if we just purchased the development rights, which is a conservation easement. So then the farmer would purchase the title to the land. Basically, that means that we would pay for half of it. The development rights cost normally about half of the appraised value. And then the title with that easement on it would cost the other half. So it brings down the cost for the farmer, because that's a big part of this, is not just having open space, but having working farms and helping to get farmers on those properties. And then it allows us to have more funds to do more projects. And then we're not being landlords, so that's not taking up our staff time being landlords. So that's why we've moved into that model. From there, we still are required, as a legal entity holding the easement, we're required to steward that land forever. So if we conserve no more farms for the rest of our history as an organization, we still have over 1,000 acres to steward forever. That means we work with the farmer, we do annual monitoring, we help them write a stewardship plan, and we work with them on projects as the years go on, things that we either think might help the farm or that they suggest. So it's a real partnership. There's not any about you have to do this kind of work. And we work at this point just in Washington State. We have had other states call us about developing this same kind of a model. And so we hope that will spring up, because we're not looking to become national, because that's the whole focus of this, is local. Local food, local control, local farmland. And I think it would kind of go against the whole idea of it if we were to try to become bigger. That doesn't mean that maybe someday we might work in Oregon or Idaho or something that's more regional, but that's the idea, is that the local land trust has the local input. Each easement is written individually for each project. So some of them may say, from this day you have the 3 years, which is what it takes to become organic, and then at the end of that 3 years you must be organic. Some of them might say, you will be organic when it's next sold, or something like that. So each easement is written for each specific project, considering what's currently there. It almost is becoming like the demand is there, but now we need to have it backed up with not only the farmers who know how to farm that way, but the land that is organic too. And that's the biggest hardship for farmers, is that 3 years where they have all the increased costs, which is mostly labor, but they don't have the increased benefit of the higher price for organic food. We work with people like Eric. That's partly why we're excited about Eric Hawkinson, who's the farmer in this property, because he's helping to intern young farmers. He will lease them possibly 10 acres of his land to start to build a business. Because part of what we've learned, in order for people to get to work with a trust, they already have to have a business and they already have to have some money, because it takes that to get loans. Basically, in order for a young farmer to get a loan, they have to have 3 years of a successful business to show to the creditors, for them to be able to get a decent interest loan. In the next 3 to 5 years, we're going to focus on Snoqualmie Valley and the Puyallup Valley in Pierce County, because those are the most threatened parts of our state as far as development and actually being able to feed the local growing population. And then afterward, or while we're doing it, do some studies to see if building this idea of an agricultural corridor actually has a tip-off or a tipping point benefit to encourage more of a farm community, perhaps spur some other farming businesses to support those farmers, and if that can be used as a model to go from county to county throughout the state. I think that's what we would like to do, is be able to come away from that saying, this is how we work, and this is our criteria, and step by step, take that to counties as they're most threatened throughout the state.